Now, sir, kids around my age feel irritated, annoyed, and angry soon. I would like the adolescents, I would like to invite your views or tips for the kids like me to improve and develop a pleasant persona on how to bring the behavioral change. Quick cool tips for us, because you said that you were a you were a teacher at a bank for 35 years on how to make your behavioral change and all of that. So can you please explain how to do this?
Okay, for children, no, first of all, they should go outdoors and play vigorously. A lot of physical games, not on the mobile, not on the iPad. Outside, you go play football, basketball, volleyball, cricket, whatever you want, you play kabaddi. So a lot of physical exercise until you perspire, you feel tired and you just want to go home and take a hot shower. So a lot of interaction in the form of play with your
peers.
Okay, so that is one thing. Then once you come home, deeply involve yourself in studies, because here you will get the understanding, deep understanding. This will shape your future. You have to study very seriously, not just to pass the exams. Involve very deeply in the studies and develop a few good hobbies and involve yourself very deeply into those hobbies, all the positive hobbies. And whatever field you want to shine in, you should read the biographies, autobiographies of the successful people in that area. And then you have to be very good mixer with people, your seniors, juniors, and equal level people. You have to mix with them, have a lot of chat, positive talk, and always respect people and have very warm and cordial relations. So in this way, you won't have any stress. And right from your younger age, I would suggest that you do a bit of yoga, pranayama, and some meditation in the morning. That will give you peace of mind, and there will be no tension of body, no tension of mind. You will be always happy. And we are going to talk. Maybe you'll ask me about laughter yoga. So you laugh a lot for no reason. And if you laugh, you get a lot of feel-good hormones inside the body. So you'll feel happier. So with your friends, you laugh. With your dadi, mommy, everyone, you laugh a lot. Cut a lot of jokes. And for no reason also, you just laugh. Call somebody and start laughing. The other person will also laugh. It is infectious. And you'll feel happier.
Yes, sir. And laughter also increases blood.
Yes.
So that will also happen. Sir, now can you please share your happiness mantra? And is it like same for all of the people? And I would like to know about that, because that is the main thing that you do. And I want to hear what is your happiness mantra, because happiness is actually not now so common. It is not common actually. If when you go out on the streets, you may see like people sulking, you may see people looking into the phones, but you may not see a person talking or being like happy. So that it is a very major issue, it is a very big issue. And so can you please share your happiness mantra, and is it same for all?
Okay, so everyone wants happiness, but everyone seeks a different route to happiness. So different persons may get happiness from different sources. I'll tell you some of the sources from where you can get happiness. They're very simple things. Let us start. Walking. Early morning walks in nature or in a park or cycling or swimming. These activities give you happiness. People may think that these are exercises, but I tell you, exercise is equal to happiness. You have to be active. And once you are active, you are happy. So walk, run, play, all these things will give you happiness. And as I told you just now, early morning is the time to do some yoga, some pranayama, and some meditation. Those who are not doing this may find it a bit strange and they may take time to begin. But once you start doing it, you are in a different world. So spend a few minutes in the morning with your body, with your breath, and with the peace of mind. That fragrance of that will linger on for the whole day. And then the day begins when you go out with whomever you meet, you smile at them.
Yes, sir.
Try to say a few good words, positive words, even with strangers. And if you smile, if you always say positive things, people will also say positive things to you.
Mm.
And whatever you are doing, for example, you are running a YouTube channel, you are studying, so be fully involved, very deep into it. When you are studying, you should not see what is around you, what is the time, whether you are hungry, whether you are tired. If you are going to work in an office, be totally involved, be fully there. If you are doing business, be fully devoted to that. So in the daytime, whatever is your activity or whatever you're doing, your profession, you should be doing wholeheartedly, fully into that.
Yes,
in the
sir.
Evening, come back with your friends, with your family. You spend a lot of quality time, not just sending messages, being one-to-one with them.
Or yes,
on
sir.
A phone, video call, and just share positive things, a lot of laughter, a lot of smile, especially if you have grandparents at home, small kids at home, even your own parents, brothers, sisters, you should mingle with them. Just pull, push, and lot of physical activity, lot of talking with them. This will give you a lot of happiness. Plus, in your life, you should do something meaningful.
Yes,
connect
sir.
To a good, peaceful, and meaningful cause like environment or education. Just like you're doing a very noble thing in the field of education. If you're doing something meaningful in life, some good work, you'll always be happy.